Just like everyday people, smart people too are prone to making silly mistakes. Gwynne Shotwell, President and Chief Operating Officer of SpaceX, may have mistakenly and unknowingly revealed SpaceX's internal plans for their upcoming orbital flight. But what exactly happened? Well, you'll find out in just a second, but first please don't forget to subscribe to our channel Futurephile to watch more fascinating videos on futuristic tech. On June the 14th, Gwynne Shotwell delivered Northwestern University's commencement address to the class of 2021. Speaking virtually, Shotwell gave Northwestern students an overview of her career, especially focusing on the nearly two decades that she has worked for Elon Musk's SpaceX. As one of the company's first employees, Shotwell has been with SpaceX from its early startup days to now, a space company with almost 10,000 employees and a market capitalization of $74 billion. Shotwell says, "The one accomplishment that we have that I am most proud of is helping to get our country flying astronauts again on American-made rockets and spaceships. We are now positioned to fly astronauts from all over the world on our Dragon spaceship, and later this year, we'll fly the first all-civilian mission, where regular everyday people will travel to space on a multi-day journey around Earth. And this is just the beginning." SpaceX indeed has ambitious plans for the future. SpaceX is currently developing its next-generation Starship rocket, which will be able to deliver cargo or as many as 100 people at a time to the Moon or Mars. The prototypes of Starship are actively being tested at the company's production and launch facility in Boca Chica, Texas, with the first orbital test scheduled for July and longer-range flights scheduled for 2022. With such an ambitious timeline, we can imagine how hectic the rocket testing activities in the remote beach town of Boca Chica have been. Musk's employees often work long hours with little to no sleep on their busy days, and that was pretty much visible in Shotwell's video. Shotwell's commencement video included a view of the SpaceX factory, where employees were hard at work. But that wasn't all that was disclosed. Shotwell also revealed the production process of the Raptor engines, along with the estimated completion date for all 35 Raptors. That includes 29 engines of the Super Heavy booster and 6 engines of the Starship, 3 of which are vacuum engines. But how? SpaceX doesn't really disclose its plans until the very last minute. There is no way the company would provide such sensitive information so easily. Indeed true, because the information was accidentally revealed. Shotwell went past an infographic showing the engine configurations on the Super Heavy booster and a countdown of 25 days at one point in the video. There are 11 circles highlighted in green and another 24 circles highlighted in white. Since the release of Shotwell's video, many people have provided their own interpretations as to what the infographic really meant. One Twitter user named Everything SpaceX says, "We believe the green represents engines already shipped and the countdown represents how many days until all the engines that are needed for Starship Super Heavy's first orbital launch are shipped. This is just speculation, however." Now, if you didn't know, the Starship upper stage is expected to be 50 meters, 160 feet tall, and 9 meters, 30 feet in diameter, powered by 6 Raptor engines. Likewise, the Super Heavy booster stage is expected to be 72 meters, 236 feet long, and 9 meters, 30 feet in diameter, powered by 29 to 32 Raptor engines. However, according to Musk, Super Heavy of the next prototype will only feature 29 engines. Well, at least for now. One Twitter user said, "There appears to be a mounting point for a 9th Raptor in the center, which would mean a total of 29 Raptors once the outer ring of 20 is added." To which Musk replied, "29 Raptors on booster initially, rising to 32 later this year, along with thrust increase per engine, aiming for more than 7,500-ton thrust long term. TW around 1.5. Moreover, Musk also revealed that Raptor engine production is ramping up, with one engine being manufactured every 48 hours. Raptor production is approaching one every 48 hours, Musk says. This makes for 3.5 Raptors a week and 14 per month at the current pace. Now, the reason we are bringing this up is because of the green and white highlights in the picture. Who knows, maybe these highlights were referring to the number of engines that are now available." One Twitter user says, "This means 25 days till engines are ready, 48 hour per engine, 9 left to be made on Super Heavy, is about 18 days. Not ready engines are shown in green. 3 left for Starship means 6 days, both added thoughts equals about 24 days, engines shown in green are yet to be completed." That could be possible if we look at the picture as he suggests. That's because, like we previously said, each Raptor engine is built every 48 hours. so the calculation would make perfect sense if the green were assumed to be the incomplete ones. However, many others have refuted this viewpoint. One Twitter user says, "I'm guessing that the countdown is for when the engines will be done, not for when the flight will be." I believe the 9 green engines in the diagram shows the engines that are completed, with the white ones being incomplete. Plus, the orbital launch complex is nowhere near ready. That could be possible as well. If SpaceX were to gear up for its next test flight of Starship, it would need its orbital launch tower in place. That's because the next Starship prototype will be the first to fly into Earth orbit. On May the 5th, a Starship prototype successfully completed its first high-altitude test flight, soaring nearly 6.2 miles, 10 kilometers, into the skies above SpaceX's Boca Chica site in South Texas, and then touching down safely back at the facility. However, even before achieving that milestone, SpaceX had started planning out the first Starship flight to Earth orbit. For instance, in March, Elon Musk tweeted that SpaceX was targeting July for that historic trial, which will require both parts of the reusable Starship system, upper stage Starship and the Super Heavy booster. Super Heavy was not involved in any of the test flights yet. However, in mid-May, we discovered the details of the upcoming orbital test, thanks to a document filed with the US Federal Communications Commission, FCC. The plan is for the Super Heavy Starship duo to launch from Starbase and the massive first stage rocket to splash down in the Gulf of Mexico, approximately 20 miles, 32 kilometers, off the Texas coast, about 6 minutes later. The upper stage will have to go to Earth orbit before returning to a soft splashdown approximately 62 miles, 100 kilometers, off the northwest coast of Kauai, Hawaii. Construction of the Super Heavy that will be involved in that flight is well underway, and so is the launch tower that will catch Super Heavy. Furthermore, SpaceX is also building orbital launch mounts to hold Super Heavy boosters and support Starships to prepare for the next launch. But how will these two new designs work together? A reusable Super Heavy first stage booster will detach from the Starship and return to Earth for a vertical landing during an orbital launch attempt. SpaceX eventually intends to use grab weapons on the launch tower to capture the descending first stage. After catching the Super Heavy booster, the first stage will have four wings attached to its body to prevent it from falling. Also, it will rotate a distance so that it puts the Super Heavy in the correct position of the orbital launch mount. At this point, the clamps on the launch table are adjusted to fix the first stage. The capturing tower will then release the body of the booster and rotate back to its original position, and the wings will also turn down and then be installed before the next launch on the orbital launch mount. To put such designs into practice would require years of refinement and experimentation, which should be rapidly monitored and relaunched. But what's really waiting next is the upcoming orbital launch of Starship. If the next orbital flight is indeed within the next 25 days, it will take place on July the 9th, 2021. But if not, we can still guarantee that it will be quite an event whenever the orbital test happens. So what are your thoughts on the recently revealed date? And even more importantly, do you think the Starship will be launched as per the predicted date? Share your thoughts in the comments section below. If you liked watching this video, you may also watch the video on the evolution of SpaceX Starship, shown in the end screen. See you there.